What's up, Rich Squad? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Dominic Rich. And if you're new around here, consider hitting the subscribe button and click the little bell to become part of the notification squad. Another win in the bag in this match, week 7 fixture versus Brighton Hove Albion. This puts us on top the English Premier League table on 19 points, still unbeaten this season, 6 wins, 1 draw. This loss puts Brighton in 14th, only 5 points, you know. They're back 3 points versus Man United, who actually lost earlier versus West Ham. So both teams are going through a tough time this season. Brighton actually just want to stay up. And for Man United, Mourinho seems like he just wants to hold on to his job. But man, Manchester City, could we actually successfully defend our Premier League title for the first time ever? We have Chelsea. We have Liverpool looking really good this season. And these two teams actually play each other today. Chelsea hosts the game. I'm hoping that Chelsea actually wins the match. You know, if Chelsea wins the match, I think we have a better goal difference than Chelsea. Let me check. Yes, we do have a plus 18 goal difference, I think. And we should still be on top of the league table with, you know, Liverpool actually, you know, losing a game. Chelsea still unbeaten. Man City still unbeaten. So it seems like we might just have a Premier League title race on our hands. But for this game, man, Manchester City, 2-0. 29th minute goal scored by Raheem Sterling. Beautifully set up by Leroy Sané. And the 65th minute goal scored by Sergio Aguero, who got on the end of a play he started, set up by Raheem Sterling for his 206 goals in Manchester City colors. Pretty impressive stuff. Man City, of course, guys, you know we bossed the possession, 81% compared to 19% possession by Brighton. Like, wow, unbelievable stuff. Just control the game. Let me find the stats for you. I'm gonna pull up the stats right now. I let you know, 850 passes completed compared to 210 passes completed by Brighton. And that's not completed, I mean 210 passes. It was only 65% completed. So it was a blowout, man. It was a blowout. They're just lucky it was a 2-0 and it wasn't like a 5 or 6, you know. Pep Guardiola must be happy. I feel really bad for Chris Hughton, who's just trying to keep Brighton up this season, just like he did last season. Pep Guardiola chose to go into this game with, we had Zinchenko in left back. I like that move, you know. Delph, he haven't been playing really good in the past couple matches, so it's really nice for Zinchenko to get a look in. We had Laporte, who seems like he's the main man for Pep Guardiola in the center back this season. Otamendi, Kyle Walker, Fernandinho. We had the two silvers in the middle, Raheem Sterling on the right, Sané on the left, and up top Sergio Aguero. We later saw Gabriel Jesus coming on for Aguero. We had Mahrez coming on. And we had young Phil Foden, who scored his first goal for the club in the midweek, coming on as well. So, Manchester City, man, we are looking good. We are looking really, really good. Picking up where we left off last season. It was a little bit more emphatic last season. But, you know, now that a lot of teams expect us to play the same way, you know, they're coming into the games with a different game plan and all of that, but it doesn't seem to be working, you know. Maybe they need to go and talk to Nuno Espirito Santo and ask him, how did you achieve that draw versus Manchester City? But another win in the bag, 19 points, still unbeaten this season. Awesome stuff. We had quite a few more games playing the same time. We had Everton defeating Fulham 3-0. That's a big victory by Everton right there. We had Newcastle losing to Leicester City 2-0. Wolves defeating Southampton 2-0, like I predicted. Arsenal defeating Watford 2-0. And Tottenham defeating Huddersfield 2-0. It was a lot of 2-0s. A lot of 2-0s. Actually, we had 5 2-0. And earlier, West Ham defeated Man United 3-1. We have the Chelsea versus Liverpool match coming up. I hope Chelsea dismantles Liverpool It won't happen like that, but I'm just hoping, just so, you know, Liverpool could like lose a game and we could be a few points ahead of them. That would be awesome, because every time I see a Liverpool fan, it's just mouth, 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 mouth. So that would actually humble them. But guys, another routine fixture, man. I don't have anything more to say. I expected a win from City. They play Hoffenheim in their next Champions League fixture away, and hopefully we don't see another upset, man. I can't deal with that. We lost to Lyon, and I can't do with another Champions League, you know, loss to Hoffenheim. And then next Premier League match day, we will face Liverpool, a team who we have lost our last four fixtures against. So it's a big match. Two big matches coming up in the next week or so. So come on, guys. Come on. Can't afford to mess this up. Talking to you. Yes, we can't afford to mess this up. But guys, that's all I have for now. If you have anything else to share in the comment section down below, please feel free to do so. If you're new to the channel, consider hitting the subscribe button, smash the thumbs up button, and until next time, peace out. Rich Squad!